points off, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 24-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Got it. And he goes down quickly. Second and two coming up here. Ball on the 31-yard line. Up the middle for a nice game. Nice run there by the tailback, and it's good for the first.
This young man ran with some purpose there and picked up 6 yards.
Zips it to the back. And he's tackled at about the 43-yard line. That's a nice 6-yard gain.
You get 6 yards, and that makes picking up a first down very reasonable.
Second and three coming up here. Ball on the 43. He makes his way to about the 45. What a play.
Just a simple option play here. The quarterback gives it up, and they get good yardage. Great play.
Now he tries to buy some time, and he's going to be sacked for a loss.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
From the 49-yard line, it's second down. Quick strike to the receiver. And they make the stop at the 33.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
From the 33-yard line, first down. The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Quick out to his receiver. They'll bring him down at the 14.
You've got to play with that kind of purpose to move the ball against this defense.
Here's the 8th play of the series. They go with a run. He brought down in the backfield. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 15. They'll give it off here. Brought down at about the 7-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Nice play fake. He's out of bounds at about the 5-yard line. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
Four down,
watch two. He's taken down at the three.
Brad, you just don't see this very often anymore in college football. That is their fifth first down on this drive alone. They have great rhythm right now as an offense. And look at that poor defense. They're looking over to the sidelines to the defensive coordinator for some help.
Touchdown, MSU.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
And he adds the extra point. A 12-play, 77-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. And down he goes at the 21-yard line. Louisville's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go.
Brad, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
Second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 19. Makes the catch and look out. He goes out of bounds.
Right around the 24-yard line.
Pressure with the pass incomplete, and that'll bring up a punting situation.
It's a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. What a collision! Not a bad return.
Last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
From their own 40-yard line, second down. Michigan State is up 7. He steps out at the 43-yard line, just about 3 yards there.
That's a nice catch by the junior wide receiver, but an even better effort by the defense to keep him from going anywhere.
They come out in an empty backfield. He gets rid of this one, so that'll make it fourth down.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Brought down at the 13-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Down he goes at the 21. That's a that brings us. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Here's the run right. He's got nowhere to go. Pitcher's duel in that low-scoring first quarter. 7-0, Michigan State.
we're back for more action here in quarter number two. And he's tackled after positive yardage. From their own 25-yard line, it's first down. Made at the 35.
And he's sacked. The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive lineman. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
So the sack makes this a second and long. That's a great tackle at the 19-yard line. So another third down here, and this time it's third and long. Throws it deep. Almost picked off. So they couldn't pick up the long yardage, and now they'll have to punt.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on the pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He's tackled at the 43. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Michigan State is up by a touchdown. He fights forward to about the 43. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 43. Nice run there. Solid 5-yard pickup there on the halfback option. Taken down right around the 34. That makes it first and 10. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 34. And they got it.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. He throws left. Looking for his man, incomplete. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. Sorry. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Quick pass. Tackle at the 27-yard line.
Number 99 makes the tackle at the 27-yard line.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Got an opening. He's to the 40. He's tackled at the 41-yard line. Fires out to his wide out, and he is drilled at the 46-yard line. From the 46-yard line, first down.
That was really a remarkable catch. The quarterback didn't throw a good ball, but the receiver made a great play.
That makes it first and 10.
Big hit there to stop him. But he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
From the 31-yard line, second down.
Lost the ball, fumble.
And they fall on the loose ball.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Somebody jumped early down there.
False start. Offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
It has the distance, and he splits the uprights. Louisville lines up for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail-biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Immediately tackled.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Michigan State holds a 4-point lead. Out of bounds at the 46. Quick throw out to the receiver. A pickup of 4 on the play.
He took what the defense gave him that time, which is okay. It keeps the yards to go a little bit more manageable.
From their own 46-yard line. It's second down. Slings it out there incomplete. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and he shoved out of bounds around the 45-yard line.
That brings us fourth and 7.
Okay.
knocked out of bounds at the 20.
You know what? It might not have been a lot, but they moved the ball forward. Football's not a game won 100 yards at a time. You take what you can get.
And they make the stop
right around the 28-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
We've reached halftime, and we couldn't have asked for a better first half. The Spartans lead it by 4.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being. And we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit. But great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 25. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out. That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Fires that quickly to the tailback. They'll bring him down around the 20-yard line.
Gain of 9 yards. That makes it second and 2.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Complete, and he's hit hard behind the line. Loss of about 2.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
Brought down at the 14. That's not going to move the sticks.
Yeah, this defense played some sound football out there and did a good job of not letting them get into any kind of rhythm.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. Looking for the corner. Tackle made at the 40-yard line. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Michigan State is up 4. Gives it right side. Tries to get around the corner. He gets to about the 27-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 27.
Herbie went to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury. We still don't know the severity, but the bad news is he hasn't reappeared. Doesn't look like he's going to play any more football today.
He's on the run. Diving for extra yardage. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's taken down right around the 20. And they back up 3 yards on that play.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Second and 13 coming up here.
Ball on the 20-yard line. Give to the tailback. And they hit him in the backfield. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They put everyone up on the line. He makes it out to maybe the 7-yard line. Michigan State is up by four. He's going to try and scramble. Nice move, and he scores. And he converts the extra point. A 7-play, 40-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. So the score now, 14-3. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Spartans continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Quick throw to the tight end. Tackle made at the 47-yard line. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Here's the throw to the fullback, and he's taken down around the 49-yard line.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and 6.
Quick out to his receiver. Tackle around the 30-yard line.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
First and 10, ball on the 30.
Decisions because he doesn't have any time to throw the ball. That's going to lead to turnover.
He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. He really got a hold of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive. down immediately. Second and six.
Ball on the 24-yard line.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick. And he muffed it. That's three down and one to go. Michigan State's in front by 11. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. And he just gets rid of it.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 29. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. Looks like the defense was in man coverage there, fellas, and that's why they stopped that screen.
Yeah, and when the secondary isn't dropping back into zone, it makes it difficult to have success with that kind of screen play.
Looking for his man, incomplete. Excellent punt. He's to the 40, and they push him out
at about the 43-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
And they get nice yardage on that run. They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Let's go, let's go!
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Receivers got the first down. He's tackled at about the 39-yard line. Time. Room around the corner. He lost the ball, and no one can get it. It bounces out of bounds. From the 24-yard line, it's first down. And he's tackled at the 15-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
They're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. got the corner.
Nice catch on that one.
And they make the stop at the 18. It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Well, he caught it, but it's almost no yards gain, and now it's fourth down.
Give props to the D here for coming up with a big stop on third down.
The kick is up, and he's got it. Michigan State gets set to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Kirk, this defensive lineman has made a statement with his play tonight.
But when you have a defensive lineman that's able to control the football game from the inside, it forces the offense to have to account for him on every single play. And he's done just a tremendous job of just being involved in a lot of plays today.
And for Michigan State, this would be a gigantic victory for them if they can make it stick. They couldn't get anything going on that last drive. Bounds at the 29. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. He's to the 40. Just under 2 minutes in the game. It's caught, and he's brought down quickly.
That makes it 7-6.
He fires left side.
Number two, the intended receiver.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. He's out of bounds.
Now that's how you run a corner route. He exploded out of his cut and beat the man coverage for a new set of downs.
Steps out of bounds at the 32. Second down of 7 coming up here. Ball on the 32. He launches one for the end zone. Touchdown, Louisville. And that touchdown gets these guys right back in the game. We're looking at a one-score ball game now. He makes the PAT. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Just over a minute left. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. From the 43-yard line, second down. They'll bring him down around the 42-yard line. And he gets a yard on the run.
We've watched this guy play, and over the course of his college career, he's made some spectacular tackles. Nice play.
And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. So So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Louisville's coaches have got to be confident in the fact that they've got a star player in a tight situation.
And there's nothing better than having a quarterback you have confidence in these kind of situations. You know he's going to make the right read. He's going to give his receivers a chance to make a play on the ball. And they're going to have a really good chance of moving the ball down the field to have a shot to win this game.
Quick throw. Brought down right around the 30. The spike will stop the clock. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. Fires quickly to the tight end. Oh, so close to breaking it. Stops the clock with a spike.
That makes it second and ten.
It's second and ten. Ball on the 30-yard. So they'll have one last shot here to possibly tie this game up. They'll need their prayers to be answered if they don't want to lose this one. He rifles it to the left. Tipped away.
That was a nice play to close on the ball like that. You can't teach that kind of reaction. It's just natural ability.
Is in and it's picked off by the safety. And this one's all but wrapped up. The Spartans come out on top 17-10. Going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.